Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn what the term data wrangling means and how it fits into the overall data science pipeline. The term data wrangling may sound unusual to you, and it is sometimes used interchangeably with data transformation. Where does this term come from? Going to the dictionary, the word wrangle is a verb that means to tend or round up cattle, horses, or other livestock. So it's a word you would use when talking about cowboys and ranching. By analogy, wrangling data would mean to tend and round up digital information by collecting it, cleaning it, and organizing it. It is an informal word, but data scientists will understand what you mean if you use it. In practice, completing these kinds of tasks requires the use of data transformations. As a helpful visual reminder, you can recall this cartoon when you hear the term data wrangling, where we have a cowboy rounding up binary data and organizing it into different pens. It is important that we have a set of tools available for cleaning and organizing datasets, as visualization libraries like ggplot2 require us to have clean and tidy datasets available. Up until now, the datasets you have been provided with as examples, such as the MPG dataset, have been carefully chosen as they are small and nicely organized. It would be nice if all datasets came to us looking like this, but they're the exceptions to the rule. Most raw datasets need cleaning, and as an informal poll of data scientists by Forbes magazine found, this is what data scientists will spend most of their time doing. Data wrangling should be viewed as a pipeline, not as a single procedure. The R for Data Science textbook splits data wrangling into three segments: import, tidy, and transform. Import is the stage where data scientists obtain data and read it into R. Depending on the format of the raw data, this step alone can consume a lot of time and effort. The tidy stage is where data scientists reshape rows and columns to follow the tidy data rules, which we will learn about later on. The transform stage is where you continue cleaning the dataset, which is not the same as tidying, and where you slice and dice the dataset for the purposes of exploration and analysis. We will start by learning the tools that will help us accomplish tasks related to the end of the pipeline, and work backwards from there. The data transformation functions we will use come from the dplyr package, which, like ggplot2, is automatically loaded into our RStudio environments when we run library tidyverse. The dplyr package provides us with a grammar of data manipulation, providing a consistent set of verbs that solve the most common data manipulation challenges. The next several videos will lead you through the most important functions from dplyr by demonstrating how they work on an example dataset.